everyone, and a very warm welcome to WS Cube Tech. So guys, in our previous session, we have completed a whole module on MongoDB. In our today's session, we will be starting with a complete new module, that is OpenCV. So we will be working with OpenCV. We will see first of all that what is OpenCV, with the help of OpenCV, what all things we can do. And also I will be explaining you how images work over here. So first of all, let's understand that what is OpenCV. So I'll be giving you a small introduction on OpenCV. That OpenCV over here is open source computer vision library. So when we say OpenCV, so open source is open over here stands for open source. The CV over here stands for computer vision library. It is a huge open source library for computer vision machine learning. So when you talk about face recognition, when you talk about reading the images, making changes in the images, making the images blur, capture something from the video, or if you have seen projects where a person draws something like that from the finger and it creates an image out of that, or people, you know, with the movements of your hand gesture, they can create a mouse. These kinds of projects can be created with the help of OpenCV. So with the help of OpenCV, we can recognize face, we can read the images, we can process the images, we can identify the objects that are there, we can identify the images and even the handwriting. Or also, if you have seen the OMR sheets where we have ABCD options and for the correct option, we have to dark circle it. Those sheets can be checked with the help of OpenCV as well over here. So this is an amazing module, and with this module you can create, you can design so many amazing things. So let's have an overview on images, that how images work, how images will work in Python. So to give you a brief over here, if you have heard of FHD, HD, VGA, 4K, what are these things? I'll be explaining you that as well. So let's take an example over here. So suppose I have a grid of 10 by 10. And actually it's 8 by 8, so I have a grid of 8 by 8. So here I have a grid of 8 by 8, and if I want to write any alphabet, let's say I want to write alphabet H over here. So what I'll do, I'll go over here and write 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 over here and form an alphabet H out of zeros. Okay, so over here what will happen, wherever there is a zero, a black color will appear in that block, something like this. So I'm just not gonna color all the blocks, but yeah, I'll just show it to you. So as you can see over here, I have darkened the area with the zeros, and for the white color, I'll be writing ones over here. So wherever there is a white color, I'll be writing one over here, which is representing that one is white and zero is black here. Okay, which is actually our binary as well. So in our binary, we have two numbers, that is zero and one. And here also we are representing zero and one, where zero means off and one means on. So here also zero means a black color and one means white color. Now this is what, this is a grid of 8 by 8. Now imagine the grid of, let's say, 640 and 480, 1280 and 720 and 1920 and 1080 and 3840 and 2160. So how many pixels would be there, and about these colors? So right now over here, what we have only two colors, that is black and white. If I take a scale in between them, if I take a gray scale in between them, so I would move from 2^8, that is 256 bits over here. And I will create a scale over here, which will start from 0 and 1. And here all the shades from between black to white would be there. So I would create a gray scale over here, which will create an image something like this. So gray scales can create images like this. So you can see over here, it's all the combinations of blacks and whites and the grays over here. So here we have used the lighter shades of gray, the darker shades of gray, the darker shades of black and the lighter shades of white as well. So we have all those things over here, which has created these amazing images. Now imagine this is just a grayscale, and if we introduce RGB into it, then it would create an image something like this, that here we have three channels, that is a red channel, a green channel and a blue channel, and when an image passes from all these three channels, it creates an original image. So here also the darkness and the lightness of the color depends between 0 to 255, that means we have 0 to 255 shades of red, 0 to 255 shades of green, 0 to 255 shades of blue. And all these are numbered over here, and when the image passes from all these three channels, it gets converted into a colored image over here. So I hope guys the concepts of images are clear to you. And if I talk about these pixels over here, so here the height would be 480 and the width would have 640. This is how it works, and each of them each block over here is colored. So you can imagine when there are small, tiny blocks, the color detailing, it enhances because of that only, that there are tiny pixels and each is given a different color, or maybe if the area is same, it has the same color over here. That is why when we have 4K, it has more clarity than compared to VGA. So I hope this concept over here is clear to you. Now in this module moving ahead, we will be discussing about different things, that how we can view images in Python, and how if you want to remove the three colors, if you want to split the three colors, that is the red color, green color and the blue color from it, and how it can be done. We will be learning all those things. If you want to capture a video, if you want to capture your video cam, that means your live cam or webcam actually. So how we can capture that. So we'll be learning all these things in this module. So stay connected, guys, and I'll see you in the next session where we will be discussing about the installations. Thank you.